iOS 15, coming out in September of 2021, is going to have big implications for email marketing. Here's what you need to know, how to adjust, and how to prepare. On this channel, we typically focus on tips for small and medium-sized businesses, but this video is for businesses of all sizes, especially large brands. So what is going on? Well, there are two features relevant for email marketing in iOS 15, Hide My Email and Mail Privacy Protection. Hide My Email is minor. It lets customers generate and use unique random email addresses that forward to their personal inbox to keep their email address private. Built directly into Safari and Mail, Hide My Email allows iCloud Plus customers to create forwarding email addresses. Whenever they see an email address field, Safari will prompt them to generate and use a forwarding email address on the fly. So in this example, when I use my email address, the brand that I sign up to has that email address. And if they suffer a database breach, the email addresses, including my own, will get into the wrong hands and I could end up being spammed. Hide My Email makes an intermediate email address that forwards to my real email address, and the brand won't have my personal email address directly. If I start getting spam, I can delete the forwarding address in my phone settings. Does this matter for marketers? Well, we don't expect it to cause any major problems. The main implication we expect is that subscribers might end up creating multiple accounts, splitting their history with you into two or more profiles. Other customers may make an account with Hide My Email, forget that they've done so, and sign up again with their real email address. This will be annoying, but not a major issue. Customers who sign up with Hide My Email will still be recorded as any other customer. We'll still be able to track them, their browsing behavior, and trigger flows like the abandoned cart and browse abandoned as normal. They will receive and engage all emails as normal. So now on to mail privacy protection. This is a much bigger deal. The first time customers open Apple Mail after they update to iOS 15, they'll be presented with this screen, or one like it, with options to protect mail activity or not. The way it's worded, we expect most customers to opt to protect mail activity. When they do so, Apple will activate email security for that account. What that means is that Apple will preload images remotely before customers open the emails. Since email opens are tracked with an image pixel, image loads won't necessarily mean that the customer opened. When customers do open on Apple Mail, it will hide the device in the open report on your email marketing platform. Now, for those of you who've been around in email marketing for a while, you might be asking, doesn't Gmail already preload images? Well, kind of. In 2014, Gmail started caching images. Here's how that works. Firstly, let's split this down into the two events, when an email is sent and when an email is opened. And then there's three components. There's the email sending server, in this case Nike, the Gmail server, and the Gmail app on your phone. When Nike sends the email, the text and the code of that email is sent to Gmail, which then sends the text and the code to your app. When you open the email, initially you can only see the text without images. As you open, the app requests the images. The Gmail server then requests the images from the email server, which then sends the images back to email, and that reports the open. The Gmail server then sends the images back to your phone. This all usually happens in less than 2 seconds. When this happens, Gmail hides the device information, so the email server can see when the email was opened, but doesn't know which device it was opened on. So how is the new update from Apple different? Well, the sequence of events happens in a different order. As before, the email server sends the text and code of the email to the Apple server. However, before Apple sends the email content to the app on your phone, Apple immediately requests the images from the email server and hides the fact that it's being requested from an Apple Mail customer. The email server then sends those images. The server then reports the email was opened, even though the customer hasn't even received the content yet. Only then does the Apple server send the email to the customer's app. From this point, the email server doesn't receive any additional open information. When the customer opens the email and images load, images will be requested from the Apple server directly, which already has the images. It delivers the images to the customer's app, again without the email server being aware of it. In fact, it's designed specifically for this purpose, to hide if and when the email is opened. To summarize, both Gmail and Apple obscure the device information. However, since Gmail requests the images when the customer opens, as marketers, we will still know if and when customers open emails. In comparison, since Apple will load images for all customers, it will look like customers who use Apple Mail will be opening the emails even if they don't. Apple users account for about 50% of our clients' customers. Industry-wide, it's between 10 and 60%, so a change to such a popular platform impacts everything. Open rates are basically completely unreliable for Apple Mail, and since they'll be hiding the device altogether, we won't know when customers are using Apple Mail, probably tainting the open rates for all apps. To be clear, you will still see open rates in your reports, but those open rates will be significantly overreported. It will look like many more customers are opening when they're not. Basically, we recommend that you won't be able to use open rates. Platforms like Klaviyo, MailChimp, Salesforce Marketing Cloud, and OmniSend may update their products to soften the impact, but none have announced anything yet. So what can we do to prepare, assuming we just can't use open rates going forward? Well, firstly, when is it happening? Apple always releases iOS update in the middle week of September. 80% of customers typically upgrade before December. Most customers auto-update iOS now. Since this update taints the pool, we recommend you act as if open rates are unreliable pretty much right away. Plan to have no reliable open rates from 13th of September. August will be the last full month of reporting with open rates. So how do you adjust for these updates? Well, firstly, everything else will still work. Clicks, revenue, browse behavior, all of this will still work. It's just open rates. For some things, we'll be able to use clicks instead, adjusted for the lower baseline, of course. For example, in the engaged audience definitions, instead of being defined as 6 or 7 month open window, we recommend extending it to a 9 month window and using clicks instead. So instead of a 6 month open window, use a 9 month click window. For monitoring deliverability and sunsetting subscribers, we'll need to make more major adjustments. We also won't be able to run subject line A/B tests since we won't know open rates very well. So we recommend you run as many as you can in the meantime to learn lessons that you can carry forward. We need to adjust deliverability monitoring, and you need to use other metrics to define engaged audiences. And you need to update the way subscriber sunsetting works. So how will we monitor deliverability? How will we know if emails are landing in the spam filter? One of the key ways we usually monitor deliverability is open rates across devices. So without open rates, we won't be able to monitor as much. Customers can use any email address with Apple Mail, so monitoring deliverability for all email domains like Gmail, Hotmail, Yahoo, and so on will be impacted. Since we won't be able to monitor deliverability as much, it will be even more important to follow best practices. I won't go into every factor here, and check out our video on deliverability in the top corner and in the video description, but some factors include using text as live text, not having too many images in your email, verifying your domains, and avoiding spammy content in subject lines. For example, avoiding all caps, dollar signs, percentage off, and other spam content flags. And finally, how do we adjust our sunsetting automations? The sunsetting email is a single email that is automatically sent to customers when they become disengaged to encourage them to re-opt in. Typically, if they don't open or click this email, they'll be automatically removed from the marketing list. This is very important for deliverability, since sending to disengaged customers will eventually mean more of your emails will land in the spam filter. Spam filters will still be judging your emails based on engagement, so it's important to continue to sunset subscribers even if they look like they're opening. You'll need to make some minor adjustments to adjust for not using open rates. Firstly, you need to remove any rules that mention open rates, since even disengaged customers may look like they're opening. Next, you need to adjust the timing. As I mentioned, you should sunset customers later than previously recommended. Instead of sunsetting at 6 months opened, you can sunset at 9 months clicked instead. Number three, have two sunsetting emails rather than the usual one. Some customers will still be engaging and opening, but we just won't know it. We don't want to risk losing them because they miss one sunsetting email. And number four, we recommend you adjust the wording. At the moment, we typically phrase it as, we see you haven't opened in a while, but since we won't know whether they're opening or not, we should instead reword it to be more like, are you still enjoying our emails? And that's it. The iOS update is the biggest shakeup in email marketing in a few years. The good news is that we expect email marketing to perform as strong as ever. We'll still know click rates, website behavior, and conversions. By looking at customers' purchase history, we'll still be able to create detailed customer segments, engage with customers in a deeper way than any other channel. If you have any questions, please let me know below. We will be answering them as quickly as possible so you can be fully prepared for the update in the second week of September. If you like this content, please subscribe and check out some of our other videos. We usually focus on tips and strategies to get the most out of email marketing, especially with Klaviyo. Thanks and goodbye.